Good morning, Holy Spirit, for making it possible for us to enjoy this new day. Heavenly Father, thank you for being the spring of living water and giving us the living water that could forever quench our thirst for God and could give this gift that satisfies our soul thirst. Lord, help us not to miss your gift of eternal life by our unbelief. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Beloved, what doubts and misgivings about Jesus do you have that hinder your faith? Realize that even the disciples doubted right up to the end, as Matthew chapter 28. Verse 17 informs us. Thank the Holy Spirit, we can commit our doubt to the Lord and ask for faith to live for Christ and have confidence in Jesus, the living word and the living water. Indeed, he will refresh our faith. In John chapter 4, verses 1 to 14, to avoid open confrontation with the Pharisees about his ministry, Jesus left Judea to Galilee and purposely went through the Samaritan territory, although the Jews did not like the Samaritans. Jesus did not live by such restrictions. The route to Samaritan was shorter, and that was the route he took. Jesus had to take rest beside a well after his long journey through Samaria. The man Jesus was foot weary, tired, and thirsty, resting by the village well. Women normally did not come to draw water at noontime, but in the cool of the morning or the late afternoons. This woman had her own reasons to avoid other women, and so she came when the others were not there to point accusing fingers on account of both her poor history and present marital status. This woman meets Jesus and never remains the same. Jesus took the unusual step of asking a favor of her. It was the first step to the most important conversation of her entire life, beginning with water from the well. She was surprised that Jesus will involve her in a conversation, because as a Samaritan woman, she's a member of the hated mixed race known to be living in sin in a public place of the world. No respectable Jewish man will talk to a woman under such circumstances. But Jesus did. Yes, the gospel is for everyone, irrespective of race and gender affiliation. Jesus broke through a barrier of racism by asking a Samaritan woman for a drink. Jesus turned the prejudiced mind of this woman right side up by offering her a better choice. John 4:10 tells us that Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you will have asked him, and he will have given you living water." Do you still allow barriers of race, tribe, sex, etc. to deprive you of God's wonderful offer, or to deprive you of reaching out to other people? Tribal and racial prejudice still keeps many of us from relating freely and lovingly with some people in our church, working place, and community. As Jesus moved the conversation from water in the well to living water, Jesus assures her that when a person takes the living water, his word, it leads to eternal life. The woman's response was that, "Sir, give me this water so that I won't get thirsty and have to keep coming here to draw water." Verse 15. The choice Jesus made to go through Samaria led to his encounter with the salvation of the Samaritan woman and her people. The choices we made in life have impact on others. To Jesus, every human being is made in the image of God and is important to God. Jesus shows a great example of how we can effectively talk to people about eternal life. As we seek to witness to others about Jesus Christ, we too must learn from his wisdom. Take time to get to know our contacts properly and seek to capture the attention in a positive manner, with due respect and caution, lest we end up giving the gospel a bad name. The image of living water, as John tells us in verse 10, which Jesus offers in a dry desert land, is very relevant good news. Yes, Jesus is the answer. Are you still thirsty for life that's satisfied? Jesus still gives the invitation. If anyone is thirsty, let him or her come to me and drink. Says Jesus. Will you respond to Jesus' invitation? Look at the open arms of Christ on the cross, inviting you this morning to embrace such invitation for eternity. Good morning. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye. Fill my cup, fill it.